I was wondering where you were.
I needed to see the daylight.
I like it here. I come here often. It's like being alone with the world. We freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changing. You seem preoccupied.
I just can't stop thinking about those two policemen. In that moment, I held their lives in my hands, and I treated them just the way the humans treat us. I mean, I did exactly what I accused them of doing.
All the media are talking about what we did last night. The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to what happened. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
It's too late to go back now. We have to finish what we started and just hope that reason prevails.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before Jericho?
I was living in a bubble in this world that belonged only to me. When you're happy, it's difficult to see other people's misery.
Where are you going?
To talk to the humans.
This is suicide. We'll all be killed. Please, Marcus, it's not too late to change your mind.
You don't understand. We're finally gonna show them who we really are. This place will go down in history.
We'll be killed on the spot.
That's a risk I'm prepared to take if it means freedom for our people.
Marcus, please don't do this.
They'll understand. We'll make them understand. This is the only way.
There are androids here who could join us. The more we are, the stronger our message.
You're free.
I'm telling you, you've got the wrong idea.
So what? You slipped and both hands on your desk. Androids are good, and they listen.
Come with us. You're awake now.
Oh, finally. I've been on hold for 10 minutes. Yes.
You're free.
We'll take instructions.
I need to block the street. Leave him alone. He's chosen to be free. You don't have to obey them.
Okay, so
you're free. You're free. Free now.
Jesus fucking Christ! Dispatch, this is Patrol 457. I got a lot of androids down here.
Set us free!
I don't know, hundreds.
Set us free!
Thousands.
Set us free!
They're marching.
Set us free!
We came here to demonstrate peacefully and tell humans that we are living beings. All we want is to live free.
This is an illegal gathering. Disperse immediately or we will open fire.
We're not looking for confrontation. We've done no harm. We have no intention of doing any. But know that we are not going anywhere until we have secured our freedom.
I repeat, this is an illegal gathering. If you do not disperse immediately, we will shoot.
Marcus, they're gonna kill us. We have to attack. There's more of us. We can take them.
If we attack, we'll start a war. We have to show them we're not violent. We should just stand our ground, even if it means dying here.
This is your last chance. Disperse immediately, or you will all be killed.
We have to show them we won't back down. We stay right here.
Disperse! This is your last chance!
We have to make a statement. We have to stay put no matter what.
Please, Marcus. We can't let them slaughter us without fighting back.
Attack!
After what happened today, the country is on the verge of a civil war. The machines are rising up against their masters. Humans have no choice but to destroy them.
I thought Kamsky knew something. I was wrong.
Maybe he did.
I'm not a unique model, am I? How many Connors are there?
I don't see how that question pertains to your investigation.
Did Kamsky design this place?
He created the first version. It's been improved significantly since then. Why do you ask?
Why did Kamsky leave Cyberlife? What happened?
I expect you to find answers, Connor. Not ask questions. Have you experienced anything unusual recently? Any doubts or conflicts? Do you feel anything for these deviants? Or for Lieutenant Anderson?
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't feel anything. You know that. Are you suggesting that I've been compromised?
No. No, of course not.
You're off the case. The FBI is taking over.
What? But we're onto something. We just need more time, I'm sure we
Hank, can... you don't get it. This isn't just another investigation. It's a fucking civil war. It's out of our hands now. We're talking about national security here.
Fuck that. You can't just pull the plug now, not when we're so close.
You're always saying you can't stand androids. Jesus, Hank, make up your mind. I thought you'd be happy about this.
We're about to crack the case. I know we can solve it. For God's sake, Jeffrey, can't you back me up this one time?
There's nothing I can do. You're back on Homicide, and the android returns to Cyberlife. I'm sorry, Hank, but it's over. Hank, what are you doing?
Something I should have done a long time ago.
Listen, take a few days to think it over. There's no rush.
I thought enough about it. I'm tired of going through the motions. There's nothing keeping me here. Not this case. Not my partner. I don't belong here anymore.
Orders, you know. Okay.
He's escaping! Stop him!
Right, I got him.
Jesus Christ. How did he manage to get out of the cell?
No fucking idea.
Hey, Connor. I'm talking to you, asshole. Where are you going? Wouldn't need any plastic pricks around here. Hey, asshole, I'm talking to you.
Hard-boiled, eccentric police lieutenant choose. Obviously. Where is Jericho? The answer's here somewhere. Not much time. The two Tracys from Eden Club, were they headed to Jericho? Did they know how to get there? The android that murdered its owner. One of the deviants that hacked the TV station with Marcus. It must have known where the deviants are hiding. Can you hear me? Rupert's diary, but it's useless. It's encrypted.
I've been dreaming about this since the first second I saw you.
Don't do it, Gavin. I know how.
And now, it's gonna be definitive.
Here. Look
out.